Hey everyone, how are you doing? Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm bringing you another budgie video. I'm going to show you the new cage I got for my little buddies and also present you to my newest flock member. So as you can see, this is the new cage I got for them. It's medium size and it has two roofs. They usually don't really fly inside. This is more like their space when they're resting and chilling and eating or bathing. So I don't think it's a big deal if it's a smaller space because during the day I let them roam around the house, and as long as I'm there with them, I pretty much let them fly all day long and I put them to bed around like 10 p.m. So let me show you close-ups of the interior and the toys and accessories I bought for them. So first off, we have this cuddle bone holder that I purchased from Feathered Addictions. It's super cute, it's very solid, and I prefer way more than some of the other cuddle bone holders I've seen on the market. They even have a tiny little perch thing that they can stand on. This is the food holder. Right now I'm trying to convert them to a pellet diet and introduce a lot more veggies and fruits. They're kind of ambivalent about the pellets. I'm never really sure if they're eating it or they're just like throwing it down at the bottom of the cage, but I do check their poop every day to make sure that they're well fed. This is one of the two stainless steel bowls that I use to put in water and sometimes fruits and veggies throughout the day. This perch right here, I actually made it myself. I went to the park and found some maple wood branch that were laying on the park ground, and I turned it into a perch. I sanded it down and also added the hardware at the end. As you can see, it got chewed on quite a bit. Niao Niao loves to trim her beak on it, so I'll probably have to replace it soon. And these are the little two buddies. So the branch that they are currently standing on is purchased from Feathered Addiction, and I believe it's Dragonwood perch. I really like it. It's a different size and I like to have perches of different diameters inside the cage so they can exercise their little feet a bit. And then at the very bottom, there's a perch lengthwise in the cage, and that one came with the cage and it's pretty much the only one that I kept. Here we have the bathhouse. I keep the bath at the bottom and they can pretty much use it anytime they want. And this is another platform style perch that I made myself from maple wood. Here we have the only toy inside the cage. It's also from Feathered Addictions. For some reason, my budgies don't seem super interested in toys. They prefer to explore and just like eat a lot. But I do alternate all their toys like at least once a week. They have a huge box of toys and I've never really seen them like pay any interest to them. I don't know why. What do you guys think? My budgies really don't like swings and they have like some sort of fear against like big toys. So here we have a calcium perch, which is the green one in the background. It's their favorite perch. They usually both like to sit on it and then trim their beaks on it. As you can see, it has a bit of wear and tear just from them chewing on it. And then right here I have a yellow treat clip, red mineral block. I wouldn't really recommend you to get this specific mineral block. It dyes their feathers red. Like right now, Niao Niao's tail feather is a little pink just from contact with this mineral block. Even when I touch it myself, my fingers get dyed. And then here's another maple wood perch that I made myself. And this is another food bowl and water bowl. Okay, so let's talk about my proudest work of art. I've never really done woodworking before, but I did some research. I went to the park and I found a piece of maple wood and then I fashioned it into this tree perch. Tree perches can be quite expensive and they're kind of cumbersome to ship around, so I decided to make one myself. I pretty much just found a nice piece of wood. I made sure that it was bird safe. I sanded it down, I sanitized it, I sawed it, and then I reassembled it into this shape. And the bottom of the stand is actually an old bed frame of mine that we decided to repurpose and turned into this beautiful stand for our birds. And here we have some birdsafe plants. I have a jade plant, I have an aloe plant, and I have a spider plant. Sometimes I find that Niao Niao likes to chew on them. I don't know why. She doesn't really like veggies, but for some reason she loves to chew on houseplants. But because it's safe for them, I don't really mind. So let's talk about our new flock member. His name is Paquito. His mutation is probably the most commonly seen, and I saw him for the first time when I was visiting a local pet store near my parents' home. He was living in a pretty crowded situation, and I pretty much decided on the spot that I wanted to get another budgie. Paquito is actually 1 or 2 year old. He's one of the older budgies at the pet store, and as a result, he was pretty cheap. I think I got him for like $15.99 plus tax. Normally, budgies go for like $35 and more. I just really wanted to get him because I know once budgies grow a bit older, like the pet stores, sometimes return them to the breeders and then sometimes they get rid of them, so they get mistreated. Paquito is still a bit of a scaredy cat. He's not very used to the environment. I just brought him home to my apartment yesterday. He's been staying with my parents for the past month, but sometimes he's still willing to come eat on my hand and chill with me. He's not exactly hand tame yet, but I see that because he spends a lot of time with Niao Niao and Niao Niao really trusts me, he seems to be more willing to accept me.